All right, here we are for round three. We're on the play. Ooh, this is our worst hand yet. A five lander with not even a collected company. I'm gonna mull this one. This would be a keep if we had a land, but we don't. Well, all right, let's do this. I don't know if that five lander was a mull, but I'm wishing I had kept it now. Boy, is this hand awful. We don't even have a stomping ground in our deck, so we can't actually draw a land that lets us cast both of our spells. Alright, looks like we're playing against a zoo variant again. I like how we ended up sideboarding against zoo, I think. I'm gonna try that again. I'm mentally assigning us a game loss here. I'm gonna go ahead and attack with Mutavault. I don't think he'll block. Maybe he will, but whatever. If he does, like, we still have to rip lands that produce colored mana to even cast our spells. So I'm fine with a trade. Like, if we draw a Sliver Hive or whatever, we'll play Sinew Sliver into Blur Sliver, and, you know, maybe that'll be good. Yeah, I didn't expect our opponent to block there. Especially if he has, like, anything decent to play on turn two. He is already at 13. Maybe we can capitalize on that somehow. Ugh, another 3/3, how rude. And suspend Riftbolt. Okay, so he's pretty burn heavy, and we're super dead. We're taking 9 this turn, plus whatever, you know, if he has like a Tarkas command or something, that's another 5 damage. So we could just be, I mean, we could literally die this turn if he has like Boros Charm Bolt or something, but no, I guess it doesn't quite do it. A Tarkas command bolt does it though. Okay. Swifty Spear. Spike us. Do you have a bolt too? That would be really impressive, actually, just a turn 3 kill from burn. Well, we're dead without casting a spell anyway. So not quite zoo. I don't think we want the same suite of removal spells, but we do want these Siphon Slivers and this Darkheart Sliver in place of Abrupt Decay for sure. Abrupt Decay I think should just not be in the deck. It is just too hard to cast without a Mana Weft Sliver. So we have to cut one more. Probably Necrotic Sliver seems a little mopey and slow. The rest of our slivers are all cheaper. And I can't imagine that we'll often have 3 mana floating around to just pop it off with. So yeah, we'll try this. This one might be okay too. It is fast at least. I'm not really sure why it's in the sideboard, honestly. Like, I don't know what matchup you're like, oh, double strike, that's what I want. I guess ones where they can't kill your guys, maybe, but those matchups seem good anyway. I don't know. I can't think of a reason for it. Anyway, we'll try this. Alright, here we are for game 2. We're on the play. And this is a mulligan because it doesn't cast any spells. This one, I guess, is a keep. We have turn 2 Mana Weft Sliver. And then hopefully we can get the ball rolling. I'm just going to lead with Overgrown Tomb tapped here. Because I think I would add, my preference is actually to cast Darkheart Sliver on turn 2 if we draw a way to do that. Who knows whether we will or not. Our opponent's probably perplexed. They probably think we're on Merfolk. And then we just led with Overgrown Tomb. Not that Goblin Guide or Monastery Swiftspear particularly care. which mopey Aether Vial creature deck you're playing. Alright. Here's the part where we pray for no Searing Blaze. It's gonna be really bad for us if we get Searing Blazed. If we don't, though, yeah, we have a puncher's chance. Ugh. Oh yeah, that is a Searing Blaze. You can tell because it takes them a little while to cast it, because they have to choose to target you and your sliver, so it just always takes slightly longer. Yeah. Yep. So now we need to draw steam vents, which we don't have a copy of. Actually, we need to draw steam vents that also taps for green or black. All right. The valiant Mutavault to the rescue. Well, it's kind of a shame to peter out like this and just sort of have our mana base fail us in the last two games. We haven't drawn a Sliver Hive or a cavern. I also am legitimately curious if the Mutavault is worth playing in this deck. It seems like it should be a shoe-in, but so far in the games, when I've like just the 2/2 by itself is really bad, and when it's been big enough to be relevant, I've had just so many other creatures in play that we don't care. And you also have Sliver Hive as a creature land already, and it would really clean up a lot of the issues to remove some number of this card. I might be totally off base. This is only the third game I've played with the deck, but that would be where I would start, actually, I think, in playing this deck going forward. Like, you get to add more swamps for Sedge Sliver, and just more colored sources in general to help, actually cast your spells. I think we are ridiculously dead here. I can't really block, because we actually need this land in play. I'm not really sure what I'm hoping to have happen here. I guess we can draw like a red source and play Sedge Sliver, and then yeah, I don't even know. The problem is almost all of our mana sources, well, I guess they don't all cost us life. Like if we draw a Sliver Hive or something. Oh god, now we take 4 damage just to cast a spell. So we can't even just yeah, we're dead. All right. Well, thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back next week. I might play this deck again. It's pretty fun. I want to just, get more of a feel for it. I might try cutting the Mutavaults or something. And I'll see you next week.